So we are largely done with the data formatting functions that are there in Excel broadly. Now we'll extend our attention to the data representation functions that come in Excel and try and understand a few of them. Data representation could be in the form of how do you show a particular table or data in a particular format, which is representation to our eyes. How do you break up data in such a fashion that it is useful for someone to evaluate or understand? How do you, let's say, sort data ascending to descending or in the ascending order or descending order? How do you grab only a portion of data out for representation? And how do you do some basic calculations on this data? So that all would kind of come in the data representation functions. While we are doing data representation functions, we will also understand how do we start incorporating formulae within Excel, right? So that's the first task that will come to our end, which is how do we incorporate formulae in Excel? So that's the next task that comes to our hand. What we're going to do is we're going to start with essentially this portion here and try and work with it and see what tasks Excel allows us to do there, right? So let's say we have this set of numbers which is given, and I want to calculate the sum of these numbers in cell number A13. I want to calculate the sum of these numbers in cell number A13. First, let's say if I can find out what is the sum of these numbers. So in general, when you link in Excel, so the first thing we'll understand is linkage in Excel. If I put an equals to and I select this cell, it says equals to A8, I can link it here, right? Similarly, I can do an equals to here and it'll link it here. What is interesting is if I now do a copy and paste of this number here, see a couple of things. Let's do a copy and paste of this 2 in cell number B9. We get a copy of 2 here. But if I do a copy and paste of this cell C in cell 10, C10, C9 to C10, it does not copy 2, it copies 3, right? That's because by default, Excel copies a formula. That's the default copying thing. If there is no formula, if there is no co formula, so this is the default access that happens in copy and paste. It'll copy and paste a formula. When you see here, this is a formula. It links this cell to another cell, right? So when I copy and paste it here, when I do a Control C and Control V here, it is correspondingly copying and pasting the formula in the subsequent cell. And that linkage is what continues as we go along, right? So similarly, I can copy and paste this here as well, and that gives me the data point. If I do want to, however, copy and paste a specific number and not a formula. Now, if I do a copy and paste of this number here, what will happen is that, look, this is looking at a cell, two cells to its left. So if I do a Control C and Control V here, cell D10, D12 will also look at a cell that is two cells to its left. So remember, this formula looks here, this formula will look here, and that's blank, so it comes as zero. Now suppose I want to paste 10 as 10, right? But remember, this is a formula, so there is a formula that is calculating something. I want to paste 10 as 10, so what will I do? I will do a Control C. On this cell, I will say paste special. You see this paste special here? There are a lot of options in paste special. We're not looking at all of them for the time being. We will click on this, and out of the headers, we will paste values. By default, it pastes the formula. But if you copy and you do a paste special saying values, it will paste the value there, right? So that's how you use paste special and paste as values. But the primary idea of this was to understand how do we create a linkage in Excel. So I can link a particular cell here to another cell somewhere else and say that this is the calculation, right? Because I can link it here, let's say I have to calculate the sum of these cells, I can just do a calculation of 1, put a plus, 2, put a plus, 3, plus, 5 plus 10, and when I press enter, it gives me the summation of these cells, right? So this is the total that I have calculated. If I double click on it, it also displays the formula that I have written, right? Now that's easy to do if there are only about 5 or 6 or 7 values, but if there are 200 values, what do you do, right? So I will delete this. That's where, interestingly, on the menu bar that you see on the top, you find this auto sum function coming helpful. If you click on auto sum here, it will insert a formula there. The formula uses a mathematical function called sum, and it sums